I've been hunting and fishing in these parts for years.
Damn bears are driving me crazy!
Nice to finally meet someone who can follow simple instructions. Here's your reward, as promised. Now if you'll excuse me, I have to get back to work.
My business is falling apart, my apprentice never listens to me, and now there's talk of dragons. If I hadn't sunk every bit of gold I had into my mill, I would have picked up and left Iverstead long ago. The Greybeards stay away from me, and I stay away from them. Suits me just fine. Friends like you are hard to find, and very valuable to me.
Thank you. got nothing on me. If you're looking for Skooma, head on downstairs.
Hold it. If you're going downstairs, you keep your weapons to yourself, or we'll be getting better acquainted. Head on in, and behave yourself.
We've seen you here before, have we? You can buy from me, then join any booth you'd like. You seem tense. Join a booth and relax a bit. Or did you need another fix? Since it's your first time, sure. Find a booth and enjoy.
You're that one from Helgen. Barely made it out of there myself. I hurt my back and I just need something for the pain.
The last of them. Horsehods can't resist after they get a taste of your dosed skooma.
The water from the spring makes the skooma so much more potent. We'll have all the thralls we'll ever need. Good thing the boss heard that old farmer running his mouth off in the tavern about finding this place.
Go! So why don't you just drink the blood from the spring? I mean, that seems easier than running a skooma den.
The boss said it's some sort of profaned spring. It looks like blood, but it's not the real thing. Drinking it gives you strength, but it also gets you pretty messed up. That's why we thought of putting it in the skooma.
Harkins no favor. Dead so soon after joining the family.
We're just lucky I was here to return the chalice to Gungalmo so we could make sure Harkon gets it back.
Wait, what? That's not what we agreed. We take it back together.
Idiot. You didn't really think I'd let you walk out of here either, did you? Gungalmo wants you both dead.
Well, that's just fine. Orthyal told me to finish off anyone who got in the way.
Never should have come.
Yes?
Hey, watch it! Hey! Oh!
I'm a loyal servant of the Lord of the Castle. Nothing more.
I see you have returned. Lord Harkon will be pleased. You met Stolf and Salonia, I assume? Lord Harkon and I suspected they might follow you there. As well you should have. Welcome to the politics of Lord Harkon's court. Vingalmo and Ortheolf both long for our Lord's throne, but cannot make overt moves against him. Each sought to gain power by using his underling to kill you and keep the chalice for himself. By ensuring the chalice reaches our Lord, you have increased his power over them, and at the same time, deprived them of their little pets. You've done Lord Harkon two great services. Take what you've learned to heart, and be careful who you trust. Now, I believe that Lord Harkon wishes to speak with you. I am above the petty squabbles here. I have lived for far too long to be bothered with them. I saw more than enough political maneuvering in my time in house dress. I was tired of it then, and I'm tired of it now. I have never understood the Nord fascination with weapons. Magic is so much more versatile, don't you think? Speak with Vingalmo. He has something for you. Until next time.
Way, and I won't tear your arms off. Simple, isn't it?
Sit down and enjoy yourself.
I hope you find life in the castle to be to your liking.
Until next time. Politics bore me terribly, but they're a fact of life here.